Good morning, everyone. So welcome to our discussion video recording for our chapter number 14, which is talking about the digestive system. So ito po ang topic natin today, the digestive system. So we are going to talk about the different organs that are found in our digestive system, as well as the basic processes that are included in this system, no? Ano yung mga function ng iba't ibang parts ng digestive system, and how does the digestion process happen, no, within this system. We will also describe the characteristics of the GI tract, and we will discuss the structure of the different components, such as the oral cavity, your teeth and tongue, your salivary glands, the pharynx, esophagus, stomach, pancreas, liver and gallbladder, small intestine, and large intestine. So basically, we're just going to really dive in sa components ng ating GI tract or gastrointestinal tract. You can also call it as the alimentary canal. Okay? So let us start with the organs of the digestive system. So the digestive system includes organs of the alimentary canal, or what we call the GI tract or gastrointestinal tract. Okay? So this is actually a tract coming from the mouth, no, starting from the opening of the mouth towards the anus. Okay? So mouth, pharynx, esophagus, stomach, small and large intestines are the organs included in the alimentary canal or GI tract, which is included in the digestive system. And we also have what we call accessory digestive system organs. So nandito na na-include natin yung inyong teeth, the tongue itself, the salivary glands na used for releasing saliva, and then we have the liver, the gallbladder, and the pancreas. Okay, as you can see here in the picture, nandyan po ang complete, no, na diagram ng mga parts ng ating digestive system, specifically the GI tract and the accessory organs. Okay? So let us move on to the digestive processes. So we have a couple of digestive processes. Now, these are actually definitions of terms that is pertaining to the different processes happening inside your GI tract. So the first one is the ingestion. Now, maybe this is your favorite part of the function of the digestive system. Ingestion, or the taking of food, no? Food intake, yung pagkain. That is called ingestion. And then we also have the propulsion. So this pertains to the movement of food through the GI tract. So yung pag-flow or pag-move ng ating chewed food galing sa ating mouth papuntang stomach and small and large intestine. Okay, we also have what we call mechanical digestion, or the process that physically mix or break foods down into smaller fragments. So in short, ang other term po natin sa mechanical digestion is the chewing. Okay? So yan po yung process of chewing, mechanical digestion. Okay? And then we also have chemical digestion. O, kabalik tara ng mechanical, di ba? When you say mechanical, ginagamit mo yung inyong teeth and tongue and the mouth in order to chew the food. But in chemical digestion, this is a process of digestion in which you are breaking down the food using different types of enzymes. Okay, so chemical digestion uses enzymatic processes to break down your food. Letter E, we have absorption, or the transport of products of digestion through the intestinal mucosa into the blood. So after we chewed the food, no, after nating break down yung solid food, kailangan magkaroon, or after the breakdown of the food using enzymes, we must absorb the different nutrients, no, coming from the food. So that is what we call absorption process. And then the last one we have, the defecation. Okay. Defecation, or elimination of the undigested residues or feces from the body. Okay, so syempre, meron tayong parts ng mga ng food that are not digested, no, by our intestines. So yung mga parts na hindi naman na-absorb and na-digest, we are releasing them, no, through the form of fecal material. Okay? So those are the processes. Okay, now let's move on to the function of the digestive system. Ang main function lang, we have only one main function of the digestive system, and that is to break down food into simple chemicals that can be absorbed into the blood and lymph and utilized by cells. Okay, so yan lang po ang main process natin, or the main function of our digestive system. So yun nga, digesting the food, no? Very important, because digestion of food keeps us alive. Okay? Kaya nga, di ba, kapag meron tayong cases in which the food is not digested, it calls for a really extreme medications or treatment from the doctor. Kasi once affected ang ating digestive system, the intake of nutrients and the supply, you know, of required nutrients to the body is also affected. Okay, so we have two types of absorbing transport systems, no, para sa ating nutrients. You have your circulatory system, specifically pertaining to the blood, and you have the lymph, no, of the lymphatic system, which actually transports fats and lipids. Okay. End products of digestion. So, we have four end products of digestion. Number one is your carbohydrates, no? So, ang carbohydrates natin, kapag na-digest siya, ang final product niya is the monosaccharides. Okay, so ano ba yung mga monosaccharides natin? You have the glucose, no? Number one is the glucose, because glucose is actually the most usable form of monosaccharide. Okay? So, yan po. Very important ang ating monosaccharides in the in providing energy for the whole body. Number two end product is the fat, no? Fats that are digested into fatty acids and glycerol. So, if you've taken already the biochemistry, so ang pinag-uusapan doon, di ba, is macromolecules. So, ang fats natin, or specifically lipids, ang final product po niyan pagdating sa digestion is the fatty acids and the glycerol, which are the monomers. Okay, monomers po ang fatty acids na lipids. And then we have also the proteins that are digested into amino acids. So, monomer din po ng protein ang amino acids, if you still remember. And number four, other end products, such as your vitamins, your minerals, and water. Okay? So, yan po. Yung mga end product lang ang na-absorb ng body natin. Okay? So, we really need to digest the polymers or yung mga bigger molecules into smaller ones, which are the monomers. Kasi monomers lang ang inaabsorb at tinatanggap ng inyong body. Okay? Okay, let's go to the general characteristics of the gastrointestinal tract, no, GI tract. So, ito na yung sinasabi ko na alimentary canal. So, first one, general characteristic na pwede nating i-describe is the structure of the wall. Okay? So, the wall of the alimentary canal consists of four walls. Meron tayong apat na covering. So, number one is the mucosa. Okay? Mucosa or the lining. Okay? So, ang mucosa natin is actually the innermost layer of the GI tract. So, it is composed mostly of epithelium, lamina propria, or lamina propria, and then pwede rin siyang composed ng ating muscularis mucosae. So, this mucosa actually lines the lumen or the open space, no, within your digestive tube or gastrointestinal tract. Okay? So, siya ang lining, innermost lining ng lumen or opening of your GI tract. your mucosa actually has finger-like projections called villi. No, yung sa loob ng lining ng mucosa, meron siyang tinatawag na structure called villi. And ang main function ng villi natin is it increases, no, the surface area for absorption of nutrients. Okay, so dumadagdag itong mga finger-like projections natin sa pag-absorb ng nutrients from the food. And your mucosa, kaya nga mucosa ang kanyang name, meaning pertaining to mucus, right? A sticky substance. Your mucosa contains goblet cells. And if you still remember, ano nga ang goblet cells natin, di ba? Meron din tayong goblet cells sa respiratory tract natin. So the most function or yung main function ng ating goblet cells is it secretes mucus to make the lining of your GI tract smooth, no, for proper food propulsion or movement. Okay, so main function ng ating mucosa is for absorption and secretion. Okay, it absorbs nutrients and secretes digestive enzymes or digestive acids. Okay, number 2 is your submucosa. So this is a layer of dense, irregular connective tissue or loose connective tissues that support the mucosa. Okay? So mas dense, no, or yung ating submucosa kaysa sa mucosa natin. Okay, what else? External muscle layer, number 3. So when you say external muscle layer, ito po yung muscles na nagko-contract, no, para magkaroon ng movement inside our gastrointestinal tract, no, para ma-move natin yung food galing sa bunganga pababa sa ating stomach and sa ating small and large intestine. So may mga muscles pa rin within the walls of your GI tract, no, yung sa mga tube. And we have 2 types of smooth muscle layers. Okay? Ang external muscle layers po natin ay may 2 types, no? Smooth muscle layers, which are called, number 1, the inner layer, which is known as composed of circular smooth muscles. Okay? Yung inner layer niya is composed of circular smooth muscles, while the outer layer, yung 2 type, is composed of longitudinal smooth muscle. Okay? So, meron tayong circular-shaped muscle, meron din tayong longitudinal-shaped smooth muscles. Okay? So, itong 2 muscle na ito, ginagamit po yan sila sa process ng peristalsis. Okay? Ano po yung peristalsis, ma'am? No? When we say peristalsis, this is the rhythmic wave of contraction inside your GI tract, no? To move food down through the gut. Okay, galing sa bunganga, nagkakaroon po tayo ng movement ng food, which is called peristalsis. No? The contraction or the rhythmic wave of contraction ng ating circular and longitudinal smooth muscles. Okay, so yan po ang peristalsis, which is produced by the external muscle layer. And the number 4 structure of the wall is your serosa. Okay, this actually contains blood vessels, no, and lymphatic vessels and nerves. Okay? So ang serosa natin, meron siyang supply ng blood. Okay? So this is the outermost layer of the loose connective tissue. Okay, so I hope naintindihan kung anong pinagkakaiba nitong 4 na structure ng walls ng GI tract. Okay, next. Let's go to the movement of alimentary tube. So, motor functions include mixing and propelling movements. So, ito daw, pag sinabi nating movements of the alimentary tube, no, ito yung movement within the walls of your GI tract openings. No, yung mga tube ba, kumbaga. Okay, so di ba nagmo-move ang walls ng inyong gastrointestinal tract, right? So, this is the motor function. Okay. Mixing of the food within the stomach and propelling of the food towards the small and large intestine. So, peristalsis, yung sinabi ko kanina, which is contraction, no, of the walls of your GI tract, is responsible for propelling movements. Okay? Okay, let's go to innervation to the tube. Okay, ano daw yung mga innervations ng mga tube natin? The alimentary canal is innervated by branches of sympathetic and parasympathetic divisions of the ANS. Okay, autonomic nervous system. So, yun nga, this means that your GI tract, no, yung mga tubes sa GI tract ninyo is controlled by the sympathetic and parasympathetic divisions. Okay? So, kapag parasympathetic impulses ang na-transmit or na-send, no, doon sa inyong digestive system, ang mangyayari, it increases digestive processes while sympathetic inhibits. So, nagpapabilis daw ng digestion ang mga signals na nanggaling sa parasympathetic area or portion while nag-i-inhibit naman ng digestion process ang sympathetic area. Okay? So, kapag mabagal ang digestion ng food ninyo, for example, so meaning active ang sympathetic area but of the ANS. But if ngayon at maya't maya ay madaling nagugutom, no? Baka always kayong gutom. That means that your parasympathetic area is more active. Okay? The sympathetic impulses contract certain sphincter muscles controlling the movement through the GI tube. So, paano daw ini-inhibit, no? Paano, kumbaga pa, pinapabagal ng sympathetic area ng ANS yung digestion process? By opening and closing, no? More particularly closing the sphincter muscles na nagko-control doon sa movement ng food, no, through your GI tract. So, ano ba ang sphincter muscles? Sphincter muscles are kind of circular muscles, no, that are found all over your GI tract. No, bilog sila ng mga muscle na pwedeng ang movement nila is opening and closing. When they open, they let the food travel through your GI tract. And when they close, they do not, no, they do not let the food get out from a certain area of the GI tract. Okay? So circular muscle po sila that are normally nagme-maintain ng constriction. Constriction meaning nagko-close. Okay? Of the passage or orifice or opening ng inyong GI tract, no? So para din silang mga valves, but ang pinagkaiba nila sa valves ng heart and ng inyong mga you call this veins is that they are circular areas with muscles nga. Okay? So, hindi sila valves. Kumbaga pa, bilog sila. Makita nyo naman siguro later on, may mga picture tayo sa susunod na mga slides. No? And yun na nga, ang main function lang nila is to prevent, no, the backflow of food. For example, galing sa stomach papuntang small intestine. So, meron tayong sphincter dyan, no, na nag-close and open for the passage of food. Okay, next. So, where are we? Okay, digestive organ, structure and function. So, let's try to take one by one kung ano yung structure and functions ng mga organs found in the digestive system. So, number one is the oral cavity or the mouth. The food enters the GI tract via the mouth, which is continuous with the oropharynx. So, ang oropharynx, if you still remember, this is the middle part of your throat, no? Or pharynx. Okay. So, ang oropharynx natin, di ba, it serves as a passageway for both respiratory and digestive system. So, ayan. So, dyan po lumalabas dyan pumapasok yung food na nanggaling sa mouth. The boundaries of the mouth are the lips and the cheeks and palate and the tongue. Okay. So, as you can see here, meron po tayong mga teeth, no, for grinding the food. We also have the lips for closing the mouth. We have the tongue, mainly ang function ng ating tongue is for mixing, no, of the food. Okay, next. Okay, We also have the teeth. Teeth are used to tear and grind the food, masticating, breaking it down into smaller pieces. Okay? So when you say masticating, another word lang po yan siya for chewing, or yung sinabi natin kanina as mechanical digestion. Okay? So kapag masticated, masticating, masticate, pertaining to chewing process. Okay? So yan, ginagamit po natin ang teeth, no, for chewing. The tooth structure is shown in the picture, no, at the right side. So kung nakikita ninyo, meron po tayong enamel. So yung pinaka upper portion ng teeth. The enamel covers the crown and provides a hard chewing surface. Okay? So yung puti po na portion ng teeth ninyo is called the enamel. Dentin is within the enamel and forms the roots. And then we also have, so ito po yung yellow or fleshy colored layer. Below the enamel is the dentin. The pulp cavity contains blood vessels and endings of the trigeminal nerve. So yung nagko-contain daw po ng ating mga nerves, no? Because again, your teeth is not purely teeth or hard portion. Meron po yan siyang malambot na portion sa loob that contains blood vessels and nerves. So may nerve dyan, kaya nga kapag nakaka-feel kayo ng pain or striking sensation kapag kumakain kayo ng malamig, no? Meaning your teeth is very sensitive and the nerve is highly affected, no, by the things that are happening outside your teeth. So meaning hindi maganda ang barrier ng ngipin ninyo. Baka merong opening or baka merong decay. And meron ding mga tao na meron lang talagang sensitive teeth, no? So, ayan po, dahil inside your pulp cavity are blood vessels and nerves. The periodontal membrane produces cement, no, to anchor the tooth in the jawbone. So, makita po ninyo dyan, meron tayong cementum na portion. So, matigas na portion kung saan it holds, no, the base of your teeth. And then, we have each tooth has an enamel-covered crown and a cementum-covered root. The bulk of the tooth is dentin, which surrounds the central pulp cavity. A periodontal ligament secures the tooth to the bony alveolus. So, andyan po ang ating periodontal ligament right here on the right side, sa lower portion, no? Okay. So, those are the parts of the teeth. Now, let us go to the different types of teeth. Number one is your incisors, or what we call chisel-shaped teeth, no? So, ayan po sila yung nasa pinakadulo to the right side. Okay, so kung makita ninyo, ang shape nila is parang chisel. So, ayan, ginagamit pang putol, no, ng ating mga food. Okay, para sa mga matitigas na food. Okay, number two is your canine. So, ang shape nila is conical fang-like, parang vampira, no? So, this is used for tearing your food, no? Pagpunit ng food, especially if you're eating meat. Number three is your premolar, so, or called bicuspids. So, yung bicuspids po natin is para din siyang molar, but it does not have the third indentation, no? And then you also have the molars or broad crown, usually found at the very back of your teeth, no? Itong ating mga molars. So both premolars and molars are used for grinding your food. Okay, sets of teeth. We have at least 20 deciduous teeth to begin with, no? Pag pinanganak ka, and then it will be shed at the age of 6 and are gradually replaced during childhood and adolescence by the 32 permanent teeth. So una, nung bata pa tayo, meron tayong at least, no, kapag normal naman yung inyong mouth, merong 20 deciduous teeth. So pwedeng matanggal itong mga teeth na ito and then mapalitan nung tamang 32 permanent teeth. But in some cases, we have children na hindi naglalaglagan yung kanilang 20 deciduous teeth. And then, pagdating ng adulthood, doon natatanggal. So, ang nangyayari, hindi na siya napapalitan ng permanent teeth kasi nga lumampas na sa age, no? Ang iba, hindi agad nabubulok yung ngipin. Pagdating pa ng high school, nabubulok. So, hindi siya maganda. Kaya, in my own experience, siguro dapat bata pa lang, no? At a lower age, i-push natin na matanggal yung ngipin ng mga bata. Wag niyong masyadong ingatan kasi deciduous teeth, mga yan. Ang kanyang function is to be replaced by the permanent teeth. So, paano siya ma-replace if hindi siya natanggal, no? Baka hindi ninyo pinapakain ng matatamis yung mga bata. So, hindi nag-decay yung kanyang ipin, hindi natanggal. Okay? Pagdating pa ng teenage years natanggal. So, mahirap na siyang mapalitan ng permanent teeth kasi matigas na yung base, no, ng ating teeth. So, yun nga. Mas maganda sigurong hayaan ang mga bata na kumain ng matatamis, no, para mabulok yung kanilang deciduous teeth at matanggal. Eh, yun lang naman. Or, mas maganda pa rin is to visit, no, monthly or at least every 3 months, no, advised by the doctor, visit your dentists in every 3 months para ma-check yung ipin ng mga bata and also for the adults also. Okay? Next. So, let's go to the... Where are we? Tapos na tayo sa tooth structure, types of teeth, sets of teeth or dentition. Okay, let's go to the tongue. Okay? Your tongue occupies the floor of the mouth. Okay? Makikita siya sa base to ng mouth ninyo. It contains sensory receptors for taste. So, sa tongue natin makikita yung tinatawag na taste buds. Okay. Main function of the tongue is to mix food with saliva to form what we call bolus. So, yung bolus po natin, yan po siya ay yung food, chewed food, no, at the movement of swallowing. Meaning yung sinuswallow ninyo na pagkain na nahalo na with saliva at nadurog na ng teeth. Okay? So, kapag chewed food, that is the bolus. Okay. Your tongue elevates to push the food backward for swallowing, and it also tastes the food you eat. There are 3 types of papillae. So, yung papillae po natin, ang ibang papillae, it contains taste buds while the others do not, no? So, we have the filiform, number 1, which is the most abundant. This one is thin and spread, no? You call this wired shape. So, ito sila is makikita mostly sa front ng inyong dila or tongue. Okay? One thing that you must remember, they do not contain taste buds. Okay? Ang mga filiform, papillae natin, walang taste buds. Number 2 is the fungiform papillae. Or if singular, papilla. Okay? So, you can find them at the sides of the tongue. So, ang shape po nila is mushroom shape. And they have actually taste buds located at the near middle or cleft of the papillae. So, sa gitna ng papillae na fungiform, merong mga taste buds. And then, we also have the 3rd one, which is the circumvillate, found at the back of the tongue. If you can see here sa picture po, nasa dulo po sila. The valate papilla, if nakita ninyo. So, this one, they also contain taste buds in the medial walls of the cleft of the papillae, and they are compared to the other papillae, they are much larger, no, in size. Kung nakita ninyo sa picture, mas malalaki sila. Okay, next. Salivary glands. The salivary glands secrete saliva. Yun ang main function nila. There are 3 pairs of major salivary glands. Number 1 is the parotid. Parotid, and then we have the submandibular and the sublingual. Yung parotid ninyo found at the lower part of the ear, while your sublingual, kaya nga sub, no, meaning sublingual, sa over or below your tongue. And then we have the submandibular below the mandible, submandibular gland. Your saliva has different types of components, no, or composition. But it is widely composed of, or largely composed of, water. Okay, and the saliva contains ions, proteins, metabolic waste, lysozyme. Yung lysozyme po natin, isa siyang type ng digestive enzyme. We also have defensines and immunoglobulin A. Itong defensines and IgA, diba, these are, kumbaga pa, defense, no? Mga panglaban sa mga pathogens and microorganisms na pwedeng present doon sa kinain ninyo na food. We also have the salivary amylase, the enzyme that breaks down amylose, yung sa mga starch natin. For example, potato. So, potato is a very starchy type of food. Okay, so para ma-digest yung amylose doon sa inyong starch, okay, we use salivary amylase. And then we also have mucin, which is a highly molecular type of protein. So protein din po itong mucin natin. Okay? Usually it is used for barrier. Okay, next. So, functions of the saliva. Ano ba ang function ng saliva? It cleanses the teeth. It dissolves food chemicals to allow for taste. So, hanggang hindi na-dissolve ng saliva ang food ninyo, hindi ninyo malalasahan yung food na kinain. Okay? Kasi kailangan ma-break down muna yung solid food into smaller particles. Okay? In order for you to taste it. It also moistens your food, initiate the chemical digestion of starch using salivary amylase. Okay, now let's go to the pharynx or throat. So pharynx is also present in our respiratory system for passage of air, no? So pharynx is a passageway for food from the oral cavity to the esophagus. So dinudugtong niya ang cavity sa mouth and yung inyong esophagus. The pharynx is divided into three parts, nasopharynx, oropharynx, and laryngopharynx. The mucosa of the pharynx is stratified squamous epithelium, skeletal muscle, and its walls constrict, move food toward the esophagus. So, nagko-constrict daw ang walls ng pharynx para ipasa ang food papuntang esophagus. So, kung nakita ninyo, di ba ito ang pharynx, kadugtong niya lang ang esophagus. Swallowing occurs in three stages. No? Ito po ang process ng swallowing mechanism or what we call deglutition. Okay? Deglutition is the term used for the process of swallowing. Okay? Kapag deglutition, meaning nagsiswallow. Okay? So the first stage is of deglutition is voluntary, meaning may control ka kung lulunukin mo yung food or hindi. Diba? Kaya naman natin i-control. If ayaw mo yung lasa ng food or masyadong mainit, then pwede mo siyang iluwa. Okay? And then kapag masarap naman yung food, okay, so you can swallow the food. So voluntary po ang first step. The food is mixed with the saliva and forced into the pharynx. The second stage, on the other hand, is involuntary deglutition. Reflex actions that move the food or the bolus into the esophagus. So meaning, once na-perform mo na, nalunok mo siya, hindi mo na siya pwedeng iluwa. Okay? Mahirapan ka na because voluntary na yung pupunta-papuntang esophagus. The third stage, the bolus or fluid, when you are drinking, enters the esophagus and is transported to the stomach by peristalsis or rhythmic wave contractions. Swallowing reflexes momentarily inhibits breathing. So kapag once nag-swallow ka, hindi ka humihinga. Hindi pwedeng sabay, no? Humihinga ka at nagsiswallow. I-try nyo kaya para ma-prove natin, no? Try eating while breathing or inhaling. So, ayan. Hindi siya pwedeng sabay. Okay? Now, let's go to the esophagus, also known as the gullet. So, this is a passageway from the pharynx to the stomach. Ang naghahatid ng food or bolus daw from your pharynx or throat to the stomach is the esophagus. So, during the passage or during the movement of the bolus from the pharynx to the stomach, walang digestion na nangyayari. lower esophageal sphincter. So ito na yung sinabi ko kanina, 'di ba? Muscle sphincter. So meron tayong sphincter or muscle sphincter in between your stomach and the esophagus. Ang tawag natin sa kanya is lower esophageal sphincter, meaning esophagus or sphincter in between esophagus and the pharynx, or LES or less. So it is found at the junction with stomach that prevents backup of stomach contents. So very important po itong lower esophageal sphincter para yung mga content ng stomach, specifically yung acids, no, 'di ba, kasi ang stomach natin, it actually releases acid for the digestion of food or the bolus. Yung acid na yan, once hindi yan na-contain within the stomach, aakyat po yan doon sa inyong esophagus papuntang throat. Kaya nga, 'di ba, yung mga mayroong acid reflux, nakakaramdam ng sakit dito sa may esophagus papuntang throat, no? Nagkakaroon din ng kumbaga parang heartburn na sensation. Kasi nga, umaakyat yung acid doon sa esophagus and throat because the LES or the lower esophageal sphincter is not closing properly. Okay? Kung meron kang acid reflux or any type of acid illness, no, sa inyong katawan, ayan po, medyo damaged po yung inyong lower esophageal sphincter because it cannot contain properly the acid of the stomach, no, away from the esophagus and throat. Okay, next. Okay, now let's talk about the stomach itself. The stomach is a pouch-like enlargement of the GI tract. It is located in the upper left quadrant of the abdomen and consists of four regions. We have the cardiac, the fundic, the pyloric regions, and the body. So, yung cardiac po natin is found, kung nakita ninyo sa picture, yung kanyang cardiac orifice. Nakita nyo ba ang cursor? Okay, and then we have here the fundus, yung top portion ng stomach. And then we have the body of the stomach. And yung kanyang lower portion is the pyloric or pylorus. Okay, so ayan po siya. Parts of the stomach. The lower esophageal sphincter, this one, serves as a valve between the esophagus and the stomach. Okay, so dito po makita banda ang ating lower esophageal sphincter. Okay. The pyloric sphincter, on the other hand, serves as a valve between the stomach and the small intestine. So, kumbaga pa, ginagamit natin ang mga muscular sphincters as a division, no, sa iba't ibang parts ng GI tract. So, kung merong sphincter doon between the esophagus and the stomach, meron din tayong sphincter between the stomach and the opening of the small intestine. So, ito po siya, oh, pyloric sphincter, as you can see here. So, the pyloric sphincter prevents any backflow of digested food from the small intestine pabalik ng stomach. Okay? Gastric gland secrete gastric juice. Okay? Inside your stomach, meron tayong mga gastric glands na nagre-release, no, ng gastric juice. Secretory cells in the gastric glands include pepsinogen-producing chief cells, meaning itong chief cells na ito nagpo-produce ng pepsin. Okay? If pepsin po is a type of digestive material. Okay? If you still remember, if nakadaan na kayo ng chemistry, so kapag maalala pa, no, I hope maalala pa. So your pepsin breaks down proteins into smaller peptides, no? So digestive enzyme po yan siya na nag-digest or nag-breakdown ng proteins into amino acids. Okay, and then number 2, meron din tayong inside, no, the stomach, meron tayong parietal cells. Okay, and which secrete hydrochloric acid. So, yung parietal cells, yan siya ang nagre-release ng HCl, okay, or hydrochloric acid, which is actually a very strong type of acid. Okay, and then we also have intrinsic factors. So, also known as gastric intrinsic factor, no? So, glycoprotein po ito siya that is very necessary for absorption of vitamin B12 and vitamin B12 inside your intestines later on. So, kailangan siya para ma-absorb ang vitamin B12 inside your body. Okay? Vitamin B12 is very important for the health of your nervous system. Okay? And what else? Saan na tayo? Mucous neck cells. So, ang mucous neck cells, nagpo-produce or nagre-release ng mucus. Okay? With mucus, very important din inside the linings of the stomach. No? Para hindi ma-digest ng hydrochloric acid, for example. May hydrochloric acids inside our stomach. Okay? Do you wonder why this HCl or hydrochloric acid does not digest the walls of the stomach? That is actually because of the mucus, no? Na pinoproduce itong mucus neck cells. So, yung mucus, it prevents the digestion of the linings of the stomach by the hydrochloric acid. And then, we also have enteroendocrine cells, which secrete hormones. Okay? Now, renin is a gastric enzyme secreted by infant stomach. It curdles milk or digests, no? Nagda-digest ng milk, which help digestion of milk proteins. So, siguro nung bata kayo, since kailangan ninyo ng milk, no, as a source of nutrient, okay, meron kayong tinatawag na renin, gastric enzyme. Okay? Pagdating ng pagtanda ninyo, daan-daang nawawala yung enzyme na yan. Kaya ang iba nagiging lactose intolerant. Meaning, wala na silang enzyme na pwedeng mag-digest ng proteins or milk proteins. That's why, kapag kumakain ng dairy products or any type of, umiinom ng milk, no? Yun nga, nagkakaroon ng lactose intolerance. Okay? So, mas marami pong renin present sa stomach ng mga baby or infants. Because they need to digest the milk. Okay, mechanism that prevents autodigestion of the stomach. Paano daw natin ma-prevent, no, since the stomach is containing different types of enzymes and acids, paano daw ma-prevent ang autodigestion ng lining ng stomach? Number one, the thick mucosal barrier helps. Yung mucus na sinabi ko kanina, it forms a barrier and it is actually alkaline. So, it balances the acid within your stomach. Pwede rin makahelp ang tight junctions among epithelial cells. And number three, pwede rin makahelp ang active mitosis. So, syempre, if there are times na madigest yung inner walls ng inyong stomach, merong active mitosis, no, division of stomach cells, which replaces the digested cells, no, of the lining. The stomach is not well adapted for absorption. Water and small molecules are absorbed through the stomach wall. So, meaning, ang stomach daw natin, kaya hindi lang sa kanya nag-i-end yung digestion kasi hindi siya magaling, no, pagdating sa absorption. Ang magaling mag-absorb ng nutrients are the small and large intestines. Okay? So, ang na-absorb lang ng stomach is water and small molecules. Mixing movements aid in producing chyme. So, ano ba ang chyme? Kanina, yung food na nanggaling sa mouth mo pababa ng esophagus is bolus. Now, the digested bolus, no, inside the stomach will be known as chyme. Okay? Pag labas ng food galing sa stomach, ang tawag na dyan is chyme. Okay? So, chyme is a semi-fluid mass of partly digested food that is expelled by your stomach into the duodenum. Okay? So, that's the chyme. Peristaltic waves move chyme into the pyloric region. Okay? Sige, next. So, the pancreas. Now, besides stomach, meron din tayong pancreas. The pancreas is a retroperitoneal between the spleen and the small intestine. Makikita daw siya between the spleen and small intestine. It produces pancreatic juice that is secreted into the pancreatic duct or duct of Wilson, which leads to the duodenum. Pancreatic juice contains enzymes. Ito yung mga enzymes na pinoproduce ng pancreatic juice ninyo. Number one is the carbohydrate splitting enzyme, or we call it as pancreatic amylase. Okay? So, very important ito sa pagdigest ng carbohydrates. Now, letter B is the splitting enzyme for protein. So, meron tayong trypsin, chemotrypsin, carboxypeptidase. Okay, yan sila ay mga enzymes na ginagamit sa pag-split ng protein. Kapag lipid naman, ang ginagamit natin is the lipid-splitting enzyme called pancreatic lipase. So, lipid, ang enzyme para sa kanya is lipase. Okay? Nucleic acid-splitting enzyme. So, meron tayong, ang nucleic acids natin are the DNA and the RNA, right? So, pwede yan siyang na-breakdown through using ribonuclease and deoxyribonuclease. Okay? We also have the bicarbonate pancreatic juice that neutralizes the hydrochloric acid from the stomach into the duodenum. So, the pancreas releases an alkaline na bicarbonate juice or pancreatic juice that will neutralize your HCl. Para hindi masyadong acidic yung marireceive ng duodenum na chyme. Cholecystokinin from the intestinal wall stimulates the release of pancreatic juice that has high concentration of digestive enzymes. So, pag-usapan natin, pancreas, ma'am, ano ang main function niya? The main function of pancreas is to release digestive enzymes. Saan niya nire-release ang digestive enzymes niya? Inside the intestinal walls or inside the intestines. Okay, so meaning ginagamit ng intestines yung mga digestive enzymes na sinisecrete ng pancreas, no? For digesting the chyme. Okay, so cholecystokinin, coming from the Greek word meaning yung kole niya is meaning bile, B-I-L-E. The cysto means suck and the kinin means move. Okay? So, meaning, ang main function ng inyong cholecystokinin is to trigger the secretion of the bile, no? Okay? Coming from the gallbladder. Okay? So, this means that it moves the bile sac or the gallbladder. Okay? So, hormone ito po siya, peptide hormone of the GI tract. Responsible for stimulating the digestion of fat and protein. Okay, so maya, malaman ninyo kung ano po ang bile. No? The bile is actually secreted by the liver. And the bile is stored inside the gallbladder. So, ang naggumagawa ng bile is ang liver, while ang nag-store ng bile is the gallbladder. So, unahin natin ang liver. Okay, the liver is a lobed organ of the that is located in the upper right quadrant of the abdominal cavity overlying the stomach. The liver is composed of structural and functional units called liver lobules. So, may dalawa po tayong lobules sa liver natin. Meron tayong tinatawag na left lobule and right lobule. Okay, dalawang areas. Yung nasa maliit, okay, and yung nasa malaki. Each lobule is made up of four types of components. Number one is the hepatocytes or yung tinatawag natin na liver cells. Okay, this one. So, ito po yung dalawang lobule natin. One and two. Smaller and bigger. So, it is composed of the liver cells called hepatocytes. And then, meron din siyang mga spaces called sinuses. No? Parang doon din sa respiratory system, merong sinuses. So, meron din pong spaces within the liver. Meron din siya, it is also composed of the hepatic triad. So, composed of artery, portal vein, bile duct. So, yan po yung mga veins and mga arteries na nagsusupply ng dugo sa inyong liver is called the hepatic triad. And then we have the Kupffer cells, which are phagocytes. So, yung Kupffer cells natin, they are used as a first innate immune or protection, no, of the liver against bacterial infection. So, kung merong bacterial infection ang liver, tutulong ang Kupffer cells to phagocytize these infections. Okay. Its digestive role, ano daw yung digestive role ng liver? It produces the bile, which it secretes into the common hepatic duct, papuntang gallbladder. Okay? So, ito po ang gallbladder natin. Ito naman po ang liver. Okay? So, yung bile na nanggagaling sa liver will be pushed into the gallbladder. Bile is composed of salts, bile pigments, cholesterol, and electrolytes. So, para saan ang bile? This is a fluid made by the liver, and it ang function niya is it helps in digestion by breaking down fats or into fatty acids. So, any type of fats or lipid, yan po, ang nagda-digest po dyan is the bile. Hindi po yan siya ma-digest ng ibang types ng enzymes, mga amylase, ganyan, no? Because lipids, di ba, fats and oils are very hard to digest. So, you need bile in order to break down the fats into fatty acids. Yan po ang main function ng liver sa digestive system. The bile pigments are produced of or products of RBC breakdown. Nanggaling daw yung bile pigments sa na-breakdown or namatay na red blood cells. Okay? Okay, let's go to the gallbladder. The gallbladder, the green portion here, is a muscular sac that lies beneath the right liver lobe. So, ito po ang right liver lobe natin, yung medyo malaki, no? And it stores and concentrates the bile. The gallbladder stores bile between meals. Cholecystokinin from the small intestine stimulates the release of the bile. Okay, now let's talk about the small intestine. Okay, so medyo mahaba pa ba? Let's try to see. Okay, the small intestine extends from the pyloric sphincter. Again, ang pyloric sphincter natin nasa pinakababang portion po ng stomach, ha? It divides the stomach and the small intestine. Your small intestine, asa na tayo? It receives secretions from the pancreas and liver, complete the digestion of the food. Meaning siya po, ang small intestine po natin ang kumukuha ng bile at saka ng mga digestive enzymes ng liver and pancreas. Ginagamit niya yung bile and digestive enzymes to complete the digestion of the food. And then meaning the completion of digestion of the food is happening within the small intestine. Diyan po nangyayari ang pinakahuling digestion ng food. And besides digestion of food, nag-aabsorb din siya ng products of digestion and transport residues to the large intestine. So you have three parts of the stomach, of the small intestine. You have the pinakaunang portion niya, the duodenum, this one. And then the middle portion is the jejunum, and we have the last portion, the ileum. Okay? So ang duodenum natin is responsible for continuous breaking down of food. Okay? It is here where the chyme is mixed with the bile from the gallbladder and digestive juices from the pancreas. So, sa duodenum daw, nangyayari ang mixing ng chyme ninyo at saka ng bile and digestive juices. Okay? So, okay, this is the first part of the small intestine, right? Now, it is followed by the jejunum. So, yung jejunum natin is located between, no, the duodenum and the ileum. So, ito siya ang middle part. A main function ng ating jejunum is to absorb sugars, amino acids, and fatty acids. So, siya po ang nag-aabsorb ng end products ng digestion, which are sugars, amino acids, and fatty acids. And the last portion of the small intestine is the ileum. So, yung ileum natin, 3 meters long po siya. No? Napakahaba niya. And it ends at the structure called cecum, C-E-C-U-M. So, ang end portion po ng ileum, tinatawag na cecum. And a main function ng ileum is to absorb the final nutrients with major absorptive products such as the vitamin B12, no? And the bile acids. Siya rin pong nag-aabsorb ng mga natitira pang nutrients that are not absorbed in the duodenum and the jejunum portion. Okay? So, kumbaga pa siya ang pinakahuling filter ng nutrients. Okay. Now, let us go to the structure of the small intestine. The wall of the small intestine increase the surface area and aid in mixing the absorption. These structures include, number one, your villi. So, ito pong villi natin. Kung nakikita ninyo, yan po sila. Maliliit na finger-like, no? Structures. And then, we also have the microvilli and the, parang mali ang spelling, plica circulars. Okay? So, these three structures are used to increase the surface area for absorption of nutrients. So, yun, para hindi kayo malito, no? Ang main function ng tatlo na yan is palawakin ang surface area in order to absorb, no, maximum amount of nutrients from the chyme. Secretions of the small intestine. So, intestinal glands secrete a watery fluid that lacks digestive enzymes but provide a vehicle for moving chyme to the villi. The intestinal brush border enzymes include maltase para sa digestion ng sugar na maltose, lactase para sa digestion ng sugar na lactose, and sucrase. Mali po yung natama na ba namin dyan. Sucrase po ito. So, pakipalitan na lang po ng letter A sa inyong course pack. Sucrase po yan. The enzyme used to digest the sugar, sucrose. Okay? Absorption in the small intestine. Blood capillaries in the villi absorb simple sugars, amino acids, fatty acids, and glycerol. Blood capillaries in the villi absorb water and electrolytes. The fat molecules are absorbed in the lacteal or the lymphatic vessel. Pag sinabing lacteal, yan na po yung lymphatic vessel. Okay? That absorbs digested fats in the villi. Okay? So, diba? If you still remember, hindi nga po yung topic natin sa lymphatic system. Ang fats natin, hindi yan siya ma-absorb ng inyong blood or circulatory system. Ang nag-a-absorb sa kanya is the lymphatic vessels. Okay? Movements of the small intestine. Movements include mixing by segmentation and peristalsis. So, let's differentiate. Segmentation is the contraction of the circularis muscles in the digestive system. Diba? If you still remember, may dalawa tayong muscles, right? The circular and the longitudinal smooth muscle layer ng ating digestive tract. Okay? So, ang segmentation, contraction yun siya na ginagawa ng circular muscles or circular smooth muscles. While yung peristalsis natin, that is the product of the contractions ng longitudinal smooth muscles. Okay? So, kapag circular muscles ang nag-contract, segmentation ang ginagawa niya. Kapag longitudinal smooth muscles naman ang nag-contract, it produces peristalsis. Okay? So, we have what we call ileocecal sphincter. So, ang ileocecal sphincter po natin is the sphincter muscle found between the ileum and the cecum. Okay? So, diba, ang ileum natin is the final portion of the small intestine. Bago mag-end yung small intestine, okay, bago siya mag-open into the cecum, may sphincter dyan, no? That controls the movement of the intestinal chyme from the small intestine into the large intestine. So, yung ileocecal sphincter natin is situated, okay, at the junction of the ileum and the cecum. And it allows digestive food materials to pass through the small intestine into the large intestine. Okay. Now, we're done with the small intestine. Let's go to the large intestine or what we call the colon. So, yan po siya ang colon. Kaya kapag merong inflammation of the colon, meaning inflammation of the large intestine po yan. Okay. So, ang difference with our large intestine is that it is very short compared bigger siya, larger in size, and shorter than the small intestine. Okay. Tapos meron siyang mga hostria, kung makita ninyo yung mga kunot-kunot, no, parang pabilog-bilog na portion sa kanyang tubes, which is absent sa small intestine. The large intestine subdivides, or the subdivisions of the large intestine are the cecum and the appendix. The colon, which is the ascending, or pwedeng nahati, no, yung ating colon. Our colon is actually divided into three parts. The ascending, this one, ascending meaning pataas, no, upward. We have the transverse found in the middle, and then the descending, yung pababa na colon, okay? And we have the sigmoid portion, this one, sigmoid portion. And then we have the rectum here and the anal canal, okay? This one. So, yan po ang mga subdivisions niya. So, ang cecum, ang pinaka-opening. Okay, and then the cecum is also connected to the appendix. Tapos, the cecum will lead to the ascending colon, papuntang transverse, papuntang descending, papuntang sigmoid, rectum, and lastly, ang food dadaan na sa anus. Okay? The opening of the anal canal. Ileocecal valve. Okay. The ileocecal valve at the junction of the cecum ileum prevents backup of fecal material into the small intestine. So, tandaan, yung laman po ng large intestine is hindi na po yan food. Okay? Fecal material na po yan siya. Okay? Kaya nga, piniprevent natin na pumasok yung fecal material pabalik ng small intestine. So, yan yung trabaho ng ileocecal valve. The major functions of the large intestines are to absorb water, some electrolytes, and vitamins made by the enteric bacteria. Okay? Pag sinabi nating enteric bacteria, these are the bacteria residing inside your intestines. Okay? So, they are very symbiotic with a person. Meaning, ang kanilang presence is not harming the person. No? Pwede pa nga tayong, kumbaga pa, we can actually get nutrients from them, no, galing sa kanilang end products, no. Nagre-release yung mga bacteria na yan present sa originally present na sa inside your intestines. They produce vitamins, no. Okay. So, yan, one function of the large intestine, it contains enteric bacteria that produces vitamins. They are not harmful. Normal normal na po yan sila sa inyong body. Okay? And your digestive system also causes defecation, the process of evacuation of the food, no, residue from the body. Defecation, ito na po yung process ng pag-release ng fecal material from the anus. Okay? So, yan. Normal flora. So, ito na yung sinabi ko kanina. Enteric bacteria is part of your normal flora. Okay? When you say normal flora, these are the bacteria found in the colon that produce vitamins, especially vitamin K, and inhibit the growth of pathogens. So, paano piniprevent ng mga normal flora ang pagtubo ng pathogens sa inyong intestines? No? Ang normal flora ninyo, they compete with the food, no, or the nutrients. So, kapag may normal flora ka, mag-compete sila sa pagkain, no, ng pathogens. Kaya hindi nagkakaroon ng extreme growth of pathogens inside your intestines because kulang nga sila sa nutrients. Kasi meron silang kalaban na normal flora or enteric bacteria. The movements are similar to those in the small intestine, no, inside your large intestine. There are mass movements that occur 2 to 3 times a day. So, yun nga, kapag may mass movement, nagkakos ito ng sensation of wanting to defecate. Okay? So, baka kayo, minsan may ibang tao na hindi pinapakinggan ang movement ng large intestine. So, kahit sumasakit na ante yan, hindi pa rin nagsi-CR. Now, this will cause damage to your body kasi nga hindi nare-release yung waste products, no, yung fecal material from your large intestine. Nakapondo lang siya doon. Defecation reflex stimulus. Okay, paano daw nagkakaroon ng, di ba kapag sumasakit ang tiyan mo, if you have a good gut health, okay, yung inyong defecation is very, kumbaga pa, madalas, no? Araw-araw, maganda yan siya because araw-araw ka nakaka-release ng fecal material or feces. Meron namang iba na once a week lang, no? Kung makaramdam ng movement, no? So, meaning hindi madalas yung kanyang defecation reflex stimulus. So, paano nangyayari yan? The stretching of the rectum when peristalsis propels feces into it. So, kapag na-push daw yung fecal material doon sa inyong rectum, nagsistretch yung kanyang walls, which causes defecation reflex stimulus. So, kapag na-stretch yung walls ng rectum ninyo, nararamdaman na ninyo na gusto ninyong pumunta sa banyo or CR. Okay? Okay. What else? Okay. Defecation is a reflex action aided by voluntary contractions of the diaphragm and abdominal muscles and relaxation of the external anal sphincter. Meaning, meron din tayong sphincter sa inyong anus. Yan na siya. Diba para siyang muscle na nakikita ninyo nag-open and nag-close? Okay. So, sphincter din po. Yan siya. Ganyan po ang itsura ng mga sphincter. Yun lang nga, ang inyong external anal sphincter is found outside the body, no? The large intestine differs from the small intestine in several ways. It forms no circular folds except in the rectum. Okay? Ano daw pinagkaiba ng small intestine ninyo sa large intestine? Ang inyong small intestine, wala siyang mga folds, circular folds. Goblet, okay, villi are absent also in the large intestine. Okay? Goblet cells are very abundant, meaning maraming mucus, no, dito sa inyong large intestine. There are Paneth cells. When we say Paneth cells, these are highly specialized secretory cells, no? Ang ginagawa nila is they produce granules which contain abundant antimicrobial peptides and immunomodulating proteins. So, ang function niya nila nitong antimicrobial peptides at saka immunomodulating proteins is to regulate the composition of the intestinal flora. Okay, yung nire-release daw na antimicrobial peptides and immunomodulating proteins, okay, substances that is released by your Paneth cells are used to control, no, the growth of the flora or normal flora inside your large intestine. Okay? Number 5, the longitudinal muscle layer is localized in 3 thick longitudinal bands known as tenia coli. So yung tenia coli natin, ito yung mga longitudinal ribbons of the smooth muscle outside your colon which contracts, no, lengthwise to produce the hostria. So meaning, in short, ang longitudinal muscle layers daw natin, nagpo-produce nitong mga kunot-kunot dyan sa inyong large intestines. Ang tawag po natin dyan is hostria. Okay? Yung mga division na maliliit, bilog na maliliit. Okay? So dahil po yan sa longitudinal muscle layer. It forms bug-like sacs called hostria. I think kulang yan ng letter I. Tama ba? Okay, hostra. Or tanggalin ninyo yung letter I. So, hostria. When longitudinal muscles contract. Okay, so yun nga. Kapag nagko-contract yung inyong longitudinal muscles in the large intestine, mas na-emphasize yung hostra natin. So, I think meron yun kanina dito eh. Ay, ito pala siya, class. If you can see, ito po ang hostra natin. Hostra pala, sorry for the confusion. Hindi siya hostria. Walang letter I. Hostra. Okay? Next. Where are we? Let's go to the disorders of the digestive system. Medyo madami-dami ito, no? So, the first one is the appendicitis. It's an acute inflation of the appendix. Again, your appendix is, wala na siyang function in the body. This is actually, your appendix is a product of our evolution in which sometimes, kapag nagkakaroon ng evolution ang mga organisms, no, meron silang mga structures of the body na hindi na ginagamit. And one example of that is your appendix. So the appendix does not have any type of particular function. Okay? And sometimes when pathogens and other microorganisms enters your appendix, or pwedeng food particles, no, nakapasok sa appendix, nabubulok doon. So nagkakaroon ng growth ng mga bad flora or microorganisms that causes inflammation. So kapag nalagyan, for example, na pagkain yung appendix ninyo, yun nga, nabubulok sa loob ng appendix, it causes inflammation. And kapag may inflammation, nagproproduce ng pus. Okay, yung nana. Kaya kapag merong production ng pus, you will feel pain, no, at your lower right abdomen. So kapag ang sakit ng tiyan ninyo is at the lower portion of your abdomen, siguro lower right, no, right side of your abdomen, kindly check with your doctor kasi nga baka appendicitis po 'yan. Okay? We also have colitis, no? Colitis is the inflammation of the mucosa of the large intestine, meaning inflammation of your large intestine, okay, or colon. Diverticulitis naman is a disorder of the large intestine. Small sac-like outpockets of the colon develop from a diet lacking in insufficient fibers. So, infection siya of the diverticula, pero usually naman hindi siya ganun ka-harmful, no? But still, it causes pain, okay, kasi nga merong sac-like structures na na-form sa colon ninyo. So, every now and then, try to eat foods na merong fibers, no? Rich in fibers. Hemorrhoids. Hemorrhoids is a condition where one or more veins in the anal canal become enlarged and inflamed. So, ito medyo masakit din ito siya. Okay, so, nagkakaroon na, this is caused by chronic diarrhea or constipation. So, kung matagal na kayong may constipation, pwedeng mag-cause ng hemorrhoids, which are swollen veins in the lower rectum, which tends to bleed, no, and cause pain sa nagdudugo siya. Okay. Cirrhosis of the liver is characterized by, next natin, scarring, which results from connective tissue replacing destroyed liver cells. It may be caused by hepatitis, alcoholism, nutritional deficiencies, or liver parasites. So, ano lang siya, kumbaga pa, second product ng iba pang sakit, no? Constipation, on the other hand, a condition where defecation is difficult and the feces are hard and dry. So, kumbaga pa pag sinabi natin constipation, there is less bowel movement. Bumabagal yung bowel movement ninyo, and this results to difficult in passing of the stool, meaning hindi mo ma-release yung fecal material, no? So maybe you can this is cause, no, maybe pwede siyang ma-cause ng change in diet or routine, pwede ring inadequate intake of fiber. Kulang ka sa fiber. Diarrhea is the production of watery fecal material due to abnormally rapid movement of food residues through the colon. Ito naman, kung ang constipation is less ang inyong bowel movement, ang diarrhea naman, sobra-sobra ang bowel movement mo. So, hindi ka pa naka-form ng tamang stool, na yung matigas na stool, nilabas na siya ng body mo. So, kaya nga, ang diarrhea is characterized by production of loose watery stools. No? Medyo fluid yung inyong stool. And this is released 3 or more times in one day. Meaning, you are performing defecation 3 or more times in one day. Okay. Ascites naman is the abnormal accumulation of fluid within the peritoneal cavity. Ang peritoneal cavity po natin, that is the lining, no, of your GI tract. If excessive, causes visible bloating of the abdomen. So, lumalaki yung tiyan. May result from portal hypertension caused by liver cirrhosis or by heart or kidney diseases. So, mainly ang ascites po is only a buildup of fluid sa abdomen ninyo. So, yung gaano karami yung fluid na nagbi-build up at least 25 ml of fluid, no, inside the peritoneal cavity. So yun nga, lumalaki ang ating abdomen size, nag-i-increase din ang weight natin. You experience abdominal discomfort and shortness of breath. Okay. Bruxism is grinding or clenching of the teeth. Baka ginagawa ninyo ito, no, during night when you are sleeping in response to stress. So, can wear down and crack the teeth. Pwedeng masira, no, ang ngipin ninyo. What else? Bulimia. Binge purge behavior episodes of massive overeating are followed by some method of purging, self-induced vomiting, taking laxatives or diuretics, or excessive exercise. So, ang bulimia, kumaga pa, may phases na hindi mo mapigilang kumain, no? Uncontrolled yung pagkain mo. And then, after that, bigla kang maging conscious, so nag-guilty ka kasi sobrang dami mong kinain. So, nag-guilty ka, ang ginawa mo, nag-induce ka ng vomiting. So, yung iba, pinipilit na sumuka, umiinom ng pampa-defecate, no? Or iba't ibang klase ng gamot para mailabas niya yung food na kanyang kinain during her binge time. So, binge purge. Binge means eating too much, while purge means releasing the food or gutumin yung sarili. Most common in high school or college students, within age women and in high school males in certain athletic activities or wrestling. Okay, so usually yung mga disorder natin, class food or eating disorders, hindi lang po yan exclusive para sa mga babae, ha. Meron din po tayo mga teenager males that experience these types of disorders. Rooted in pathological fear of being fat and a need to control, provides a means of handling stress and depression. Consequences include erosion of the tooth enamel and stomach trauma or rupture because of vomiting and severe electrolyte disturbances which impair heart activity. Therapy includes hospitalization to control behavior and nutritional counseling. Eh, so takot na tumaba, no? Pero meron siyang instances na nagbi-binge eating siya. Okay. Pancreatitis naman, inflammation of your pancreas. So, a rare but extremely serious inflammation of the pancreas may result from excessively high levels of fat in the blood, but most often results from activation of pancreatic enzymes, causing pancreatic tissue duct to be digested. So, yung mga digestive enzymes na dapat nire-release sa small intestine, no, nagkakaroon, hindi siya nakokontrol, nadadigest niya yung sarili niya, the pancreas itself and the pancreatic duct. This painful condition can lead to nutritional deficiencies because pancreatic enzymes are essential to food digestion. So, kung nagkulang ka na ng mga, they call this digestive enzymes, hindi na ma-digest yung food na kinakain mo. Okay, peptic ulcer, ito para sa may mga acid reflux din, no? The acid reflux actually causes ulceration. Okay, pag sinabi nating peptic ulcer, term referring to gastric and duodenal ulcers, meaning sa sobrang acidic ng content ng inyong stomach, ano, nagkaroon na siya, na-digest niya na yung wall ng stomach ninyo. Kaya nga, nakaka-feel ka ng pain, no? Kung kumakain ka, nakaka-feel ka ng pain kasi nga, nabutas yung walls ng stomach. Ayan, o, kung nakita ninyo, yan ang ulcer, di ba? Ulcer is any type of open wound. Okay? So, nagkaroon ng open wound at the wall of the stomach. So, while the stomach is mixing the food, yung food na kinain mo or the bolus, no, turn into chyme, tatama sila dyan sa sugat na yan. So, kapag natatamaan yung sugat na yan, nakakaramdam ka ng masakit na sensation. Okay? So, yan po siya. Ang ulcer, peptic ulcer. Okay? So, that's it for today. Thank you very much. Now, we've reached the end of the digestive system. I hope na nag-take down kayo ng notes for your quiz next meeting. thank you very much for attending or watching this video. Kahit na medyo mahaba siya, 1 hour and 20 minutes, I think. Okay? So, thank you very much, everyone, and see you on our next lecture.